Thank you. That concludes the debate on dementia strategy. It's now time to move on to the next item of business, which is consideration of motion 8037 in the name of Maggie Chapman on behalf of the Scottish Parliamentary Corporate Body on the appointment of members of the Standards Commission for Scotland. And I call on Maggie Chapman to speak to and move the motion.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I am pleased to speak to the motion in my name as a member of the Corporate Body Appointment Panel to invite members of the Parliament to agree to the appointment of Helen Donaldson and Anne-Marie O'Hara as members of the Standards Commission for Scotland. The Standards Commission is part of the ethical standards framework in Scotland, and its role is to encourage high ethical standards in public life by promoting and enforcing the codes of conduct to councillors and members of devolved public bodies. It issues guidance to councils and public bodies and adjudicates on alleged contraventions of the codes referred to it by the Commissioner for Ethical Standards in Public Life in Scotland. The Commission has a convener and four members, all of whom are part-time. After the usual recruitment process, we have two people we wish to nominate as members of the Commission. Helen Donaldson has had a long and successful career in education, initially as an English teacher, then moving into more strategic roles in Aberdeenshire. As Head of Education and Inclusion in Aberdeen City, she had wide-ranging responsibilities, working closely with local councillors, outside agencies and officers from across the council. Anne-Marie O'Hara has recently retired from her post as the Chief Executive Officer of an Edinburgh-based charity and social enterprise, providing affordable space for the third sector. Ms O'Hara has worked in various property, charity and grant-giving roles. She was head of the capital team at the Big Lottery Fund and led the property planning, projects and European funding team at the National Trust for Scotland. I'm sure that the Parliament will want to wish them both very well and every success in their new roles. In closing, Presiding Officer, I want to thank the outgoing members, Mike McCormick, who demitted office on the 31st of January, and Tricia Stewart, who will demit office on the 31st of March, and to wish them both very well for their futures. Presiding Officer, I move the motion in my name.
Thank you. The question on this motion will be put at decision time. The next item of business is consideration of business motion 8064 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau setting out a business programme. And I call on George Adam to move the motion.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. And moved.
Thank you. I call on Neil Bibby to speak to and move Amendment 8064.1.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Last week, Scottish Labour formally requested two statements from the Cabinet Secretary for Health, and I made that request again at the Bureau on Tuesday, but to no avail. We are therefore proposing an amendment to the business motion to add two important statements on our NHS next week. The first relates to national treatment centres, which are subject to delays and cost overruns. 5 of the 10 treatment centres are delayed, and we understand the costs of the Livingston Centre alone have gone up from £71 million to £184 million. 770,000 people in Scotland, that's around 1 in 7 Scots, are now on NHS waiting lists. Waiting lists are costing patients their health and costing taxpayers money too. These centres are an important part of the solution. We therefore need a statement on these delays and cost overruns as a matter of urgency. The other statement required is on NHS Tayside. The Health Secretary promised over a year ago that they would advertise and recruit consultant oncologists, but this still has not happened. Women with suspected breast cancer are still having to travel out of the region. That is not acceptable. These are not the only issues affecting our NHS. Today we also learned that ICU beds at Ayr Hospital have been removed as well. That's despite Humza Yousaf promising just 2 months ago that they would be retained. The Health Secretary has apparently said he's happy to answer specific questions on these matters. That begs the question why we would not have statements to Parliament then. That would provide the appropriate forum for Humza Yousaf to answer those questions. I also understand the Health Secretary has suggested he's happy to meet with members to discuss these matters, but at least one of our members has been struggling to get time in his diary. It's clear that Humza Yousaf seems preoccupied with running his own leadership campaign than running Scotland's NHS. We believe this Parliament and the people of Scotland should hear from the Health Secretary on these important matters. There is a day job to be getting on with, and Humza Yousaf needs to get on with his. I move the amendment in my name.
Thank you. I call on George Adam to respond on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. The Scottish Government regularly updates Parliament on the national treatment centres. Most recently, in December, four national treatment centres will open this year, providing significant additional protected capacity. This programme is a huge investment in frontline planned care infrastructure and, over the next 5 years, will provide the single biggest increase in planned care capacity ever created in NHS Scotland. The Scottish Government remain committed to delivery of the programme, and there is no further update which warrants a statement at this time. NHS Tayside, Presiding Officer, the Scottish Government will continue to work with NHS Tayside and other partners across health and social care to address financial pressures and to take forward reform to deliver improved, sustainable services. On both issues, as always, Presiding Officer, I would encourage members to lodge specific questions via the normal routes available to them, and ministers will, of course, be happy to answer.
Thank you. The first question is that Amendment 8064.1 in the name of Neil Bibby, which seeks to amend Motion 8064 in the name of George Adam on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau setting out a business programme, be agreed. Are we all agreed? The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we'll move to a vote, and there will be a short suspension to allow members to access digital voting.